Thank you. Yo les dije, si me matan, voy a estar con Jesús. Ustedes me quieren matar o me quieren dejar vivir, no importa, yo gano.
My father in this world left me, but my father in heaven will never leave me.
I love my parents so much. I want them to know that I'm praying that the Lord will open their hearts and minds.
I would like to send a message to my dad. You say you want to kill me, to shed my blood in public. No matter what decision you make, I forgive you.
Many have come to me and said that they went to a church and were told not to come. That makes my heart sad.
I can't see how we are second-class believers. Just because some inherited their faith from their parents and others searched for God and found Him.
Many Christians have abandoned us. They could have helped us, but they didn't.
These people are supposed to stand with us and have a part in solving our problems.
First, the Christians were pushing us to go to the church and be at the meetings. But after I went to jail, they said, please don't come to the church again to avoid us having problems.
When a Christian is persecuted in Saudi Arabia, the church grows. The church grows, and the one who is persecuted becomes more stronger and alive, because this is the reality of your faith. Jesus said you will be persecuted, you will be hated by men. But the best thing that persecution can do in a person is it will shake the things that are not of God.
Jesus said,
we are asking the Lord to give us more boldness, to give us the strength to bear His name, and to stand strong in the face of terrible persecution.
They cannot burn Christ and the church from our hearts. We are in God's hands.
I have the Holy Spirit inside me, and He gives me the strength not to be afraid.
It was really hard, but praise God, God took every care. No one backslid, no one left Christ. They became very strong believers.
My faith was never shaken. I know that in all situations, God is with me.